Hi friends, in this session I'm gonna explain how the Spring Boot application works. Already I gave up a session on this topic, Spring Boot application, how to create a Spring Boot application using the controller, but I missed out to execute the program in that session. So let me execute a Spring Boot application now, and that's what we are going to see. All right, so in the you can go and check on the that video in my channel. All right, so in that I have already explained about how to create the how to create a class and make it as a Spring Boot application class, and then how to create a controller, how to create a class and make it as a controller class. So everything has been explained in that session. Kindly go and check on that session. All right, the session name is like S1 Spring Boot application. Right, now let me in this session I'm gonna just execute the Spring Boot application. Okay, now in this course API app application, this is the name of the Spring Boot project, Spring Boot application. So it's been created, you can see here. And one more thing I would like to make a point, like this Spring Boot application, this annotation makes the application as a Spring Boot application. You can see this application makes it as a Spring Boot application. This annotation comes from the class like org.springframework.autoconfigure.springbootapplication. Okay, fine. Let me give a quick recap on this. Just we have created a created an application. Okay, the name of the application is Course API application, and now we want to make this application as a Spring Boot application. How do we do that? We want to make this application as a Spring Boot application. How do we do that? Just annotate this the main class with annotate Spring Boot application annotation. Okay, and then this annotation comes from org.springframework.boot.autoconfigure.springbootapplication. All right, so within this course API application, we do have the main method. Here, so here you can see spring application dot run, and we pass in this class object, this class course API app application dot class and args, string args. So what does it mean? Like we want to tell the container, we want to tell the spring container that create a Tomcat server and load this course API application and make it available. All right, let me come again. So what we do with this statement, like just consider spring application dot run, there is a spring application dot run. What does it mean actually? So we want to tell a spring container that create a Tomcat server and load this course API app application and make it available for execution. So we want to tell the spring container. So how do we do that? Using this statement, spring application dot run, this code snippet, it does that. All right, so what is the spring application? It is a utility class. Spring application, it is a utility class, static utility class, and it does have a static method that is run. So within this to this method, what do we pass in two arguments. One is the class, whatever the application that has to be executed. So we here course API application dot class, so we give it here, and then the args here, string args. So whatever the argument that we pass it in the main method, that can be done here. ARG args. So here this argument, it is a pass through, right? So that's this is what it happens in the main method. And then now we have created the application. So you can see pom.xml file. Maven is used to declare all the dependencies in a file called pom. Okay. Let me repeat it. Maven is used to declare all the dependencies. Maven is used to declare all dependencies in a file. All right. The name of the file is pom.xml. So here we have declared all the dependencies that are required for the project. So Maven is used to declare all the dependencies that are required for the project in a file. The name of the file is pom.xml. Okay. So we have declared here. You can see the parent dependency and then the web dependency. We call it as a method dependency and then test dependency and one more JUnit engine. It's part of it. So now we have done the dependencies. POM.xml. Here already in that session I have stated how to define a dependency, what is dependency, and how to define a dependency. Let me make it very simple and short. Like here. The dependency is defined using the keyword dependency. Here you can see dependency. Inside the dependency, you can dependency element that is used to define the dependency. And then inside the dependency element, you do have three elements, which are those are like group ID, artifact ID, and version ID. Group ID is used to define the name of the package. Here, worthy.swingframework.boot, and artifact ID is it is the actual path for the dependency. Like if you want to spring-boot-starter-web, it is a method dependency. What does it mean, like web dependency? So it downloads all the jar files that are required for the web development application. So that's the reason we have web dependency. In other words, we call it as a meta dependency. Okay, and here you can see one more dependency. So version. One more element, that is version. That element is used to give the version, which version we want to make use of it. So, alright. So now one more thing is here. See here, for Java version, we have defined the Java versions. So properties, in the properties element, we want to use the 1.8 Java version. We want to use the Java 8 version. So Java 8, java.version element is here. We use the properties element. Inside that java.version element, in that we have defined the version, whatever the version we need. Okay, if you want to make use of some other version, 1.5 or something, then we can mention it here, and it will be downloaded and used for the application. Here one more dependency is here, test dependency. For test dependency, spring the group ID is spring org.springframework.boot, and artifact ID is spring-boot-starter-set-test. So scope here it's given test. Okay, and that's it. Web and parent dependency. So this dependency, it is this dependency, you can see spring hyphen boot hyphen starter hyphen parent. So what does it do? Like it makes this application, I mean the course API app application, as a child application, child Spring Boot child project of Spring Boot application project. So this dependency makes course API app application as a child dependent child project of Spring Boot application project. Okay, so that's so whatever the jars we want to make use of, whatever the jars or component we want to make use of, we want to I mean whatever the jars and components that are required for the application to make use of it, those things are defined here. Those components as well the jars are downloaded and it's been used in the application. Okay, and now let me come here. Hello controller, we have defined the controller. So till now course API app application and then the pom.xml Spring Boot application has been created, but it doesn't handle any request. Okay, so it doesn't handle any request. So if you without this controller, if I run the program, it doesn't handle any request. So what if I run the project, what will I get? Like I will get a empty page. I mean the browser, it wouldn't show anything. All right, so this application has to handle some request, right? So let me, I have created a controller here. How do I create a controller? Just create a class named hello controller and annotate this class with risk controller, at risk controller. This risk controller, annotate this class with risk controller to make this class as a controller. Risk controller comes from org.spring-framework.web.bind.annotation.riskcontroller. Here what do I do? Like I create a method say hi, which returns string. Inside I just written a string, new welcome to Spring Boot application. And this method is annotated with request mapping. You can see request mapping, and I pass in a value /hello. So this request mapping comes from org.spring-framework.web.bind.annotation.requestmapping. Here, so whenever this application is accessed, whenever this application URL is accessed with hello argument, or whenever this application is accessed with hello argument, this say hi method is called. Okay, so in turn this say hi method, I mean it will return the new welcome to Spring Boot application. Okay, whatever the text you give it here, that would be written as a response. All right, let's see. Let me run the program. In the previous session, named S1 Spring Boot application, I missed out to run the application. Okay, I missed out to run. Let me do it. So I'm just right click, go to run as, and I can see Spring Boot app. Alright, here it shows some identify and stop the process. I mean the port number, it seems the web server failed to start. Port 8080 was already in use, so the port number which is in use, so let me actually this application, I tried to run this application on 8080 port number, but this that port number which is already occupied by some other application. So let me do that, let me get rid of that application. All right, just hold on. Now I just give the command. I just opened the see a command prompt, and I gave net stat. So let me give it again, net stat hyphen ano, and R symbol, and then type in find str. So you will get to this will tell us which application which application occupies that port, all right, or which application may make use of that port number 8080. I forgot to give the the 8080 port number here, 8080. Now you got 1024 is the port number, I mean of the application that that uses the port number. So we need to kill off that application. So task kill --hyphen, I mean 1024 is the process ID, all right. So forward PID 1024 has been created. So that process is killed. Okay, and let me run now. Now it works fine. Started. Okay, fine. Now I'm going to the browser. Here I type http :// localhost :8080 hello. See, we got the output. the project got executed. We got the output, new welcome to Spring Boot application. All right, it works fine. So now in this session I have used the risk controller. In real time application, you may have to use a service class as well, service class and repository class, you know, to get connected to the database and fetch the data or do any kind of data manipulation. You may need two more layers, like service class as well the repository class. I will explain Spring Boot application project with the controller, service, and then repository stuff in another session. All right, thanks for watching. Bye bye.